Hello, welcome to SS United. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today we are going to discuss one more interview question that was asked in Pine Labs. So one of my friend has attended interview with the Pine Lab. So this question was asked over there. So let's move to next slide to understand about the question. So here, as we can see, we are having an input table that would have five columns. First is players, then match, then over, then run, and then wickets. So in the output, we are also having five columns with the player name, then total number of matches, then total over, then total runs, then total wickets. So in case of Karthik, he played three matches with the M1, M2, and M3. So in the total number of matches, it is going to return as 3. In the over, he bowled 2.2 overs in the first match, 3.0 over in the second match, and 3.3 over in the third match. So total number of overs would be 8.5. In case of run, 14, 22 and 12. So in the output, total number of runs is 48. He has taken 2 wickets in the first match, then 1 wicket, then 4 wicket. So total number of wickets would be 7. So this is the output. So we can directly use the count function to get the total number of matches, and we can use the sum function to directly get the run and total number of wickets. But in case of over, we can't use the sum function directly, because in a single over it has 6 balls. If we get 6 after the decimal places, then that would be added with 1 over. So how we can write the query for getting this output? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio, where we will write the query for getting the output. As I am using SQL 2017, you may have another version of SQL Server. So first of all, I would like to execute the create table statement to create the table. So command completed successfully. So table is created. Now I just want to insert record on the table, so we can execute this insert statement. So 9 rows affected. So data is successfully inserted into the table, and we can check. So here we are having the same metadata as we seen in the slide. First of all, I would like to discuss about the parseName function. So parseName function is going to get the values after the decimal places. So how we can use and we can check. So parseName, and it is accept two parameters. First with the column name. So we want to get the column name from over, and how many decimal places we want. So we just want only one decimal place. Now we can execute and check the output. So here, as we can see, 2.2, so we are getting 2. Here 3.0, so we are getting 0. 3.3, so 3. So we are getting the values only after decimal place. What would be the logic? So logic is very simple. First, I need to get the only numeric part from this over, and then this decimal part from the over. In the numeric part, that would be like 2 overs. So we need to multiply it by 6, because in a single over that would have 6 balls. So that would be total number of balls. So in case of Karthik match 1, we will get 12 plus 2, so 14. Then 3, so that would be 18. In 3.3, so we need to multiply 3 with 6 plus 3, that would be 21. Then we need to combine all the balls, and then we need to divide by 6, and if we will get anything after the decimal places, then we need to use that one as well. So let me write the query for the better understanding. So here I just want to get the player name first. So this is our player name. Second, I just want to use count with the total number of match. So we can use count with the matches, and it would be total number of matches. After that, we can use our logic. So first of all, I would like to convert this into integer to get the integer part over as integer. Now it looks good. Then we need to multiply it by 6. After that, we can use the sum, and here we need to use the parseName function as we seen. Then overs, how many decimal places we want? We want only one decimal place. And we can combine all the balls. So we can use the sum function with this, and let me call this as total balls. Then we need to use run, so we can use the sum function for the run, and directly we can use as run. Looks good. Then we need to combine total number of wickets, so again we can use the sum of wickets, and let me call this as wicket. Now as I am going to use the aggregate function, so we have to use group by clause. So group by with the player name. Now let me execute and check the output. So here, as we can see, we are having total number of balls, total number of runs, total wickets and total matches. So let me compare with the output. So here, as we can see, in case of Deepak, he bowled 7.0 over, 36 runs and 5 wickets. So here we can see 36 runs, 5 wickets and 3 matches, and total balls 42. So now we need to convert this total balls into overs. So let me put this into a CT. So this is the CT, and now we can use this select from CT. Now I need to get the total overs. So for that we can use total balls divide by 6. Now we can execute. So this time we will get, but if we will have anything after decimal place, that would be missing. So 7, 7 and 8. Now I need to cast this value as varchar. So varchar 10. Then I just want to combine dot, that is fine. Then we have to get values after the decimal places. So how we can get? So we can directly use total balls, then we can use mod with 6, and we need to also convert this as varchar. So let me convert this as varchar and 10. Now let me execute and check the outputs. So this would be the total number of overs. So Karthik has bowled 8.5 over. Now we can check. Karthik has bowled 8.5 over, Deepak 7.0 and Divyansh 7.2. So we are getting the output as we were expecting. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. And if you need this script, it will be available on the description of this video, so you can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.